Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are talking about some drugstore and affordable makeup products that are actually better than high-end. I think there are so many amazing affordable options and you don't have to spend a ton of money to get really high quality products. I actually filmed a video like this about a month ago and I had so many that I couldn't fit them all in one video and I've discovered even more since then. So today I really wanted to focus on a few underrated products that you don't hear a lot about and then also a few new releases as well and some older staples. I just have a mix of drugstore products that I think are so good that honestly, if you put them in high-end packaging, I wouldn't be able to tell the difference between these products and high-end products. If you guys are new to my channel, my name is Andrea. I love drugstore and affordable makeup. It's what I tend to focus on, and I do upload 4 videos a week, so I would love for you guys to subscribe, stick around for a little while. I will apply these products on camera so you can see what they look like. I'm wearing a few of them in today's video, but I didn't film this. So let me film some application clips, include them so you can see what the products are like, the textures are like, but let's jump into it and we'll chat about the products. The first product I want to talk about is a primer, and this is so good. It's from the brand Hard Candy. I used to love the brand Hard Candy when I first started my YouTube channel, and I think the reason I got away from purchasing their products is because I think they're only sold at Walmart, but you can also purchase them online as well. I got so many recommendations to try this product, and I just fell in love with the formula. This is the Hard Candy Sheer Envy Hydrating Primer. If you're a fan of those really hydrating, jelly-type gripping primers, like the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip or the e.l.f. Mint Melt Primer, then this is going to be a great option for you. But I think the difference between this one and the other primers that I've tried is that this one is a little bit more lightweight, so it doesn't feel as intense on the skin. It has a really nice, just like soft gel texture, and it does provide a little bit of tackiness, so your foundation stays in place a little bit better, but it's not so sticky to the point where it's hard to blend your foundation on your skin. It's just the perfect in between, and I love this one for daily wear. Even though I have oily skin, I think it works so well on oily skin, and I know people who have dry skin have said they've enjoyed this too because it locks your foundation into place so well. I've had my makeup on for over 4 hours, and normally by this point I'll start to get pretty oily around my nose, or I feel like my foundation will start to settle, it will start to cling to dry areas or textured areas, and when I use this primer, it does not move. It looks so good all day long. So this really is a great option if you're looking for a primer to extend the longevity of your foundation, but you want more of a hydrating formula. I definitely recommend checking this out. The next product I want to mention is a foundation. This is from Catrice. In my last video, I mentioned the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation, which is perfect if you're looking for a long-wearing matte foundation. But this year, they released the True Skin Hydrating Foundation, which is also really long-wearing, and it's such a good option. I know that Tati talked about this recently, so I think it's been sold out on Ulta's website for a little while because that's typically the case when she mentions something. But the reason why she mentioned it is because it really is so good. This retails for $11. It comes in 20 shades. You can also order directly from the Catrice website, and I know they are sold in some stores as well. This is a really nice, just like medium to full coverage foundation, but it doesn't look heavy or cakey on the skin at all. I think the problem with a lot of full coverage foundations is that they do cover everything that you want them to, but they can look really heavy on the skin, especially if you layer them up. The nice part about this foundation is that you can build it up in areas where you do need additional coverage, but it doesn't look like you layered a ton of foundation onto your skin. It definitely has like that true skin finish. It's very smoothing and it looks really good on the skin throughout the day. Now, they do claim that it is a hydrating foundation, and I was kind of surprised because I definitely found it to be more of like a matte foundation with like a hint of a satin finish. So I think if you have really dry skin and you need something really moisturizing, this might not be ideal for you, but I do think that it looks really good on the skin. It's definitely long wearing. It doesn't feel dry on the skin, but it does have more of a matte finish. Like I said, it's been 4 hours since I did my foundation and I haven't touched up my makeup at all. My skin is really oily and normally I have to blot like the 4 hour mark, but I just feel like this foundation wears so well on my oily skin. So I would definitely keep that in mind if you're thinking about buying it, but this truly does feel like an expensive high-end formula. I would reach for this over the majority of the high-end foundations in my collection any day. It's really, really good. The next product I wanted to mention is from e.l.f. Now, I know e.l.f. is really well known for their 16-hour camel concealer, which I love. They have the original version, which is a little bit more mattifying, and then they also have a hydrating version. I like both of those. I think they look really good on the skin, and typically I'll kind of mix them together. But last year they released the Flawless Brightening Concealer, and this is such an underrated product. It retails for $5 and it comes in 18 different shades. This is a very lightweight, natural formula. It's definitely not anything like the 16-hour camo concealer, but if you're someone who just wants really light, natural coverage, this is definitely going to be a great option for you. It provides a little bit of like a brightening effect to the skin. So if you deal with dark under eye circles, but you don't want anything too intense, this is just going to brighten up the area in a really natural way. It's very blendable, really easy to work with. It's definitely a light coverage product. So I find that if I'm wearing more of a full coverage foundation, sometimes it's nice to go in with a light coverage concealer because it doesn't feel like you're layering anything heavy on top of an already full coverage foundation. And it just gives you a little bit of brightness, a little bit of coverage. I would say if you have really dark under eye circles or if you want like intense coverage, definitely skip over this product, but it is a good option if you want more natural coverage. I've heard people compare this to, I think, a concealer from YSL, saying that it is so similar. I haven't tried that concealer myself, but this really does feel like an expensive high-end formula. There is a new product from e.l.f. that I wanted to mention. This is their Putty Bronzer. So I have the shade Tan Lines. I actually ordered a few shades and then I was like, where's my package? Because it had been maybe like 2 weeks at that point, and I went online and I actually shipped it to my old apartment that I lived at years ago. So I'm not sure exactly how that happened, but they did send me a PR package with a few shades. So I did purchase this on my own, but this is a color that I actually got in the mail as PR. But this is such a nice formula. It is so blendable, so smooth. I just recently started trying out cream bronzers last month. That was my first experience with cream bronzer, and I've tried Persona Cosmetics, I've tried Makeup by Mario, but this one is so perfect for everyday wear because it's a little bit more natural on the skin. It's very lightweight, really blendable. It doesn't have like an overly creamy finish. It definitely feels like the putty blushes if you've tried those. And I really like that formula because I feel like it stays in place well on my oily skin. So it's definitely the case with the putty bronzers. You can layer them up, you can blend them out so they're a little bit more subtle. I do have this on today with a little bit of powder bronzer that I'll talk about in a second. But in my application clip, you should be able to see how this applies to the skin. It's just really, really smooth and so pretty. They do have 8 different shades to work with. And I think, you know, with a lot of cream bronzers, they're super intense and richly pigmented on the skin, which could definitely be a pro if that's what you're looking for. But for me, I have a tendency to go overboard with my bronzer. I probably did today, honestly. So what I like about this product is the fact that it is a little bit more subtle, but it's buildable. So you can start off really soft and then add more. Whereas with the other cream bronzer sticks that I've tried, if you draw them onto your face and you have too much, it's hard to remove that and really blend it out. So these are great for everyday wear. If you are new to cream bronzer, this will be such a good option. It's definitely one of my favorite products, and it really does feel like a high-end formula, but it's only $6. I am so excited about this product. I feel like I'm probably late to the game on this because I was never really into cream highlighters, but this is so pretty on the skin. It is the Flower Beauty Day Glow Highlighting Glaze. There are 2 different shades. I have the lightest shade, Stunner, but there's also like a deeper golden shade too. This is the prettiest cream highlighter that I've ever tried. It is so soft and subtle on the skin. I just literally take my fingers and like lightly tap it onto my cheeks and it looks amazing. It looks so natural. It gives your skin like this wet, dewy look, but again, it looks natural. And I feel like you can't really get that look with powder. I have a lot of powder highlighters that I love, but I feel like overall a lot of them tend to sit on the skin or they give off like such an intense look. But this cream is so subtle and so pretty, and I just think it is perfect for everyday wear. I've been wearing it nonstop. So this one does layer on top of powder pretty well without looking too heavy, but I think it probably goes on best if you just apply foundation and then lightly tap this on top and then maybe slightly dust over that area with powder. But I don't even feel like you need to lock this into place with powder. It's almost like the longer you wear this throughout the day, the better it looks. It just kind of melts into the skin in a really natural way, and it looks so pretty and so natural and just gorgeous. It looks like what you would see in an advertisement for a cream highlighter. It's just amazing. So I think that this feels like a high-end product. It's just one of the best cream highlighters or cream products or products in general that I've tried, and it's definitely worth checking out. In my last video, I did mention a few eyeshadow palettes. There are so many amazing, affordable eyeshadow palettes. So if you want some recommendations, I'll link that video below. But an older favorite that I just love, that I think is so good, is just the ColourPop Super Shock Shadows. These are the best cream to powder shadows that I've ever tried. And I feel like there are people who've always preferred cream shadows, but I also feel like cream shadows and like one and done shadows and low maintenance makeup is becoming even more popular this year. So if you haven't tried the ColourPop Super Shock Shadows, now is such a good time to try them. They have so many beautiful colors, whether you're looking for something a little bit more neutral or you want something really bright and colorful, they definitely have one that will work for you. The shimmer that I have all over my lids today is actually a Super Shock Shadow. It's from the ColourPop Lust for Dusk palette, which they have been including Super Shock Shadows in some of their palettes, and I love that because the Super Shock Shadow formula is so intense and just shimmery and gorgeous. You get this beautiful wet looking shine, and I personally like to use them as like the finishing step in my eyeshadow look. So typically I'll apply powder shadow and then just take a Super Shock Shadow and place it all over the lid. But like I said, they're also good as one and done shadows. They apply so perfectly with your finger, which is really nice because they don't take a lot of effort. I was on Sephora's website the one day, and some high-end brands sell single shadows for like $20, $30. And there might be a formula out there that's worth that, but truthfully, I feel like I get the most intense shimmery look that I've ever gotten with these $6 Super Shock shadows. So I definitely recommend checking them out if you haven't already. So I am a big fan of the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Eye Pencils. In fact, I do have one on my waterline today. But what I've discovered over the past year is there are some really good options at the drugstore that perform really well, including the Milani Stay Put Eyeliners. These are $9 each. And what's nice about these is they are very creamy. So you can blend them on and then you can use the other side to kind of smudge them out. But once they dry down, they stay in place so well, whether you're using them on the upper lash line or the waterline. So if you are looking for like a truly long-wearing eyeliner that's easy to apply, this is going to be a great option. I have two shades. I have a really pretty like olive green and then also a deeper purple. And I just think they're such a nice option that you can truly get from the drugstore. Like you can walk into a drugstore and pick these up or order online, but they're $9 and they're really nice. One more Milani product. I've talked about this a lot on my channel, but when it comes to drugstore and affordable products that are truly better than high-end, I think this is one of those. This is the Milani Weekend Brow. Now, the only con with this product is that it only comes in 3 shades. And there are a lot of brands that do, I'm blanking out what these are called, eyeliner pens that have better shade ranges, like 8 or 9 shades. So that is something to take into account. But if there is a shade that works well for you, the Weekend Brow is probably one of the best eyebrow pens that I've tried because it's very subtle. When it comes to these eyebrow pens, it's very easy to get carried away and all of a sudden you look like you sharpied your eyebrow on. So if you are a beginner or you're new to eyebrow pens, this is such a good one to start with because it's a little bit softer and more subtle than other pens, and the tip is a little bit more tapered. So you really can get like truly fine hair-like strokes, whereas some other eyebrow pens that I've tried have like a thicker tip, so I feel like it gives me more of like that sharpied eyebrow effect. So if you are looking to try an eyebrow pen, I think you'll enjoy this one. I also like the NYX Lift and Snatch Brow Tint Pen. That one I think is under $10 too, and they do have a better shade range, but the Milani Weekend Brow is just a little bit more subtle. So if you truly don't have eyebrow hair, like I don't have any eyebrow hair in the front, I feel like I can get the appearance of that with this the best out of any of the ones that I've tried. I love this product. This is the Ulta Beauty 3-in-1 Cheek Palette. Now, Ulta Beauty does have their own in-house brand. I don't know if you would really consider it drugstore. I would consider it affordable for sure. They have it on the drugstore side of the store. You know how when you walk in, at least at my store, on the left is all of like the drugstore and affordable makeup, and then on the right is the high-end makeup, and then the hair products are kind of mixed in. This is all the way like on the drugstore side of my store. This palette retails for $15, but you can typically get this brand on sale and get it for even less. This product reminds me of Hourglass. It feels like an Hourglass product. The bronzer, the blush, the highlighter, they're all so soft and so smooth on the skin. They blend out seamlessly, and they just kind of glide over any texture that you might have. The reason why I have enjoyed Hourglass products is because the powders are so soft and fine, so it doesn't really look like you're wearing a lot of powder on your skin, and they just kind of glide over everything and almost give you like a lit from within look. Like truly, it looks like your skin is shining through. I haven't found anything like that until I tried this product. It really does remind me of Hourglass. So this one does feel like a high-end product. They have three different options. I think they also have a warmer toned one and then a deeper one as well. So there might be another one that kind of suits you. The swatches look pretty subtle, but when you apply this with a brush, you can definitely get a little bit more color. And I think that this is also great for setting cream products into place. If I go in with cream bronzer or cream blush or even cream highlighter and I want to set it so it doesn't move all day long, I like this powder because it is so light and soft, so it doesn't really take away from the smooth look of cream, but it ensures that it will stay in place well. So this truly is like an affordable product that feels like a high-end product. $15 is a little bit more expensive than some of the other products I'm mentioning, but you do get three different products in here and you get a lot of powder. I don't think I'll ever hit pan on this. So I did want to mention this in today's video. I do have a lip product from NYX as well. I think these are so underrated. These are the NYX Filler Instinct lipsticks. Now I feel like the marketing for these is a little bit confusing because if you look at these online, they look like they're going to be really vibrant and super pigmented, just really intense. But when you apply them to the lips, they're definitely on the sheer side. Honestly, I think that's perfect because you can wear them on your own if you just want to add like a hint of color. So I'll typically take the darker one. This one is called Sugar Pie, and I'll wear this as like an everyday lip color because it adds a hint of color with a nice glossy finish. But I'll take the shade Beach Please and layer this on as like a highlight lipstick. So if I'm wearing a nude lipstick and I feel like it's a little bit too dark, this is perfect. And honestly, if you're wearing any lipstick and it's kind of dry or uncomfortable, these are so perfect for layering on top because they just kind of give everything a very smooth, glossy finish without being too much. The whole claim behind these is that they're supposed to like lightly plump your lips and make them look super smooth. So I honestly love wearing them on top of my other lipsticks because some lipsticks kind of enhance all of the fine lines. They make my lips look dry even if they're not. So this is like the perfect lipstick topper. But like I said, it's also nice on its own. So if you guys haven't tried these, they're definitely worth checking out. They feel like high-end lipsticks. They really do. And I use them all the time. Okay, that's everything I wanted to mention in today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I will link everything that I talk about in the description box below, along with my original video. So if you want even more recommendations, you guys can check that one out. But thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you guys have any drugstore and affordable products that you think are better than high-end products, I would love to know. So let us know in the comment section below. But otherwise, I'll see you guys very soon with a new video. Bye.